Buntag! Ako na si Christine, and I'm just here to welcome you all to Destiny Cebu's online Sunday service. Today is really a very special day because today we are celebrating Mother's Day. So sa tanang mga mama, mommies, ug mga nanay nga nagtanaw sa ato karon, happy, happy Mother's Day from all of us. Indeed, your lives are blessings to us, your children. This Sunday, once again, we are thankful that you chose to spend your mornings with us. So, sa atong Sunday service, what would happen later, we will first have our morning devotionals, followed by the worship, and then we also have some announcements, and then the preaching. After the preaching, we have some processing questions for you to answer, and finally, the giving time. So, are you ready? Don't forget to prepare your Bibles, your pens, and your notebooks, and to set your hearts and be excited to be blessed. And if necessary, kindly also remove any distractions na pwedeng makadistract sa inyo. So if you're ready, then I encourage you to be excited.
Maayong buntag, Destiny. Good morning sa atong tanan. Did it's a wonderful morning. We are here. You are here. I believe, no, God is really happy na naa ka din. And for that, no, let's just take a few moments and i-worship na ito ang atong Ginoo. Ang kanina song, it's called Healing. It talks about how God is our refuge. Na makasalit na sa kanya. So just take this moment, just take a break sa atong Ginoo. At simbahon ng Ginoo siya. Welcome na ito ang iyong presensya.
Kagandahan mo morning, Destiny. I am Rina and I will be the one sharing Sunday's devotion. It is entitled Panimalay. Ang Panimalay, tahanan, or in English, home, is the unit of our society. Therefore, everything must be clean, pure, and right inside our homes. We must feel safe and secure in our homes before other places. Are we? In Matthew chapter 8, verse 20, Jesus replied, "Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head." Yes, you have heard it right. Jesus have no place to lay his head even if he is the Son of Man. But what makes the difference between Jesus and us as a man? It is the gratefulness of the heart that makes the difference, and it is the people with him and the presence of God that drops him. It is what a home must be for us as well. I was curious why there are increasing positive cases in the Cebu City Jail. While I was searching, I found out in the reporter's notebook that the inmates have no place to lay his head in the bars. The jail has a capacity of 1,000 plus prisoners only, but there are 5,000 plus as of 2018. They could barely even sleep during the day. Another story, Irene and I are fond watching documentaries during the morning, and it make me see the bigger world. Children, yes, they are the sacrifice. The supposedly home cannot even be recognized as one. The worst of all for me, just recently, we have discovered that the family that we call made their homes a temple of worshiping gods. They built altars of gods, and yet our families are in chaos. All of those are eye-openers. It makes me see different pictures. Can you consider it a home when you are alone in your apartment right now? Can you consider it a home when your family is a mess right now? In Proverbs chapter 4, 23, the word of God says, "Keep thy heart with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life." It is our desire to have God's idea of home. Yet, only a few knew that wherever we are is a home. Though apart from our families, we are blessed to have them safe and healthy. Though we are alone, we are blessed not to lack food to eat each day. Though we are struggling, there are still moments that makes us smile. Though we felt like our home becomes a market, ang dalampanan nato kayang atong langit ng amahan. Let us be grateful and not lose our home. This is Rina, and I am Destiny.
Thank you.
Good morning, Destiny! Maayong buntag! Welcome sa atong tanan! And of course, I'm inviting everyone to just call your friends, imong family, imong ka-boardmates or dormmates, and just welcome them! Last week, no, kauban nato ang Destiny Manila, so I'm just welcoming everyone back to Destiny Cebu. And so yun, you can just type below, baka hindi pa sila online, or hindi pa sila naka-join, and let's just celebrate on this morning other, our main part for this morning, kay welcome nato ang Ginoo. So are you excited to worship our God? Come on! Simbahon nato siya!
Just one touch is enough, Lord. Oh,
all agree, there's no power like the power of Jesus. I will believe for greater things. There's no power like the power of Jesus. Let faith arise, let all agree, there's no power like the power of Jesus.
Matatagpuan
Oh,
really God overflowing in our hearts. Lord, I'm sa giampo, may we just continue, Lord, be the center of our lives, of this church, of your people, and we pray po, O God, that ang dami, O God, ang mga kasing-kasing to really receive your word. May also, Lord, be with our pastor as she preaches, O God, and just really pray, O Lord, and help us, O God, to be really doers of your word. Lord, we just exalt your name, we just magnify your name, O God, because you're the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. I just want to thank you, O Lord, for this morning and for the rest that you're going to do in our lives. We surrender to you, O Lord. All these things we pray, in Jesus' name we say, Amen.
Hello, everyone, and welcome once again to Destiny Cebu's online Sunday service. Before tamo pa tayo, I first have very few announcements for you. First off, if you are a first-timer, of course, this is the very first time that you are joining us, then I encourage you to send us a message or leave us a comment in the comment section because we want to connect with you. And welcome to Destiny's online Sunday service. As for our other announcements, first off, for our DLT 6 lessons, ongoing gihapon na, that would be every Saturdays at 3 p.m. So if you want to join us, then pwede gihapon mo nga mo join sa mong lessons on basic doctrines every 3 p.m. Saturdays. Also, ongoing ang ato ang pag-send of daily pagdasig videos that will be uploaded on our Facebook page. So, stay tuned sa videos nato i-upload and we encourage you to also share them to your friends and to your family members so that all of us will be encouraged. Another announcement for our prayer meetings. We still continue joining Destiny Manila in their Monday to Friday Dawn prayer meeting online. That will be every 5 a.m. in the morning. And every Saturday, Destiny Cebu have our online corporate prayer meeting every 6 a.m. on Saturdays. And also, we are still ongoing sa prayer chain. So if you have a vacant time, and we encourage you to join and to enlist a slot in our prayer chain that we are doing 24/7. We encourage you to join us. And also for our life groups, we may not be meeting physically tungod sa lockdown and tungod ani nga crisis, but we are still ongoing and we're doing it online. So we have several schedules throughout the week and just contact us and so we can plug you in our online life group. And finally, we are still ongoing sa atong pag-send og hinabang sa mga kaila nato or mga kaila ninyo na nag-need og assistance during this crisis. We are still ongoing with hinabang sa nagkinahanglan. So, kung ganahan sad mo nga mo donate, we are sending usually food packs to people in need. We encourage you to contact us for your donations. And that's all for our announcements. Now, as I said earlier, today is a very special day because today we are celebrating Mother's Day. And since our mothers are very special to us, then let us all watch this video.
Isn't she lovely? Isn't she wonderful? Isn't she precious? Such a beautiful soul. Lovely, is she? Isn't she lovely? She's my mom. Isn't she pretty? Truly the angel's best. Boy, I'm so happy. I have been heaven blessed. I might be the luckiest son.
can't believe I get to be son of someone as lovely as she. Isn't she lovely? She's my mom. 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 Isn't she lovely? She's my mom.
Isn't she lovely? She's my mom.
Good morning, Destiny, and welcome sa atong Sunday service. How are you? How have you been holding up? We really live in difficult times now. Nisurge ang cases diri sa Cebu City. Kita na ang top 2 sa whole Philippines in terms of COVID-19 cases. Nihabol jud ta. And then daghan pod sa atoa naglisod financially. Many of us kay no work, no pay. And dili pod sure na inig ka lift sa quarantine kay ang company kung asa pod ta nag-work kay maka-bounce back pod. Makaingon ta karon na wala na jay stable na job. Ang mga industry before nga magingon ta na sige dira pag-work kay kung dira ka mag-work sure ball git na kay nang mass media, kay nang sa food industry, sa tourism industry. Makaingon ta nga hala, unsa na may na-happen karon? Nag-bye-bye ang ABS-CBN. Sirado, excuse me, sirado ang mga hotels. And then ang mga tourist spots kay halos walay sulod. And then ang mga food industry, bawal mag-dine-in. Puro take-out na lang. Ang kanapong mga businesses on events, lisod po, lalo na karon na bawal ang mass gathering. So unsaon naman lang pag-event sa mga inana. So karon no, ang mga tao nga qualified sa SAP, maski unsang init, maski hangtod ka lawon ng linya, makipaglinya gyud, makipagsapalaran gyud, makakuha lang og money. Very, very desperate times. And I believe dili lang pud na sa aspect sa atong finances. Many of our frontliners, they live in isolation sa ilahang families. Ang uban pud sa ato na lockdown, kuyog sa atong mga family members nga dili pud na ato kasundo. While ang uban pud nag-inusara. Grabe nga loneliness, grabe nga depression. Really difficult times. Pag i-consider pa nato ang number of cases worldwide, ang deaths worldwide, lisod gyud siya. But I praise God for this moment, this opportunity and privilege that we could gather as a church, even if virtually. Kasi we can really encourage one another and remind ourselves with the Word of God. And in this way, no, we can really find our strength, our hope in God and in His Word. The strength and the hope that we need to endure in this very difficult time. So, are you ready to hear the Word of God? We are going to continue with our series on crossing over. We have talked about the crossover of Joshua and the crossover of Jonathan. Today, we are going to talk about the crossover of Elimelech. I have entitled this message, Crossing Over. Is it a yet? Is it a go or a stay? As we begin, may I invite you to pray with me. Let's pray. Lord, we thank you for your faithfulness in each of our lives. We even thank you, Lord, for technology. I pray that you would be the one to communicate your personal message to each one of us. I pray that this would be a timely, relevant message. A message, O God, that would really speak to us, O God, and help us, Lord, navigate sa karon nga lisod nga situation. I pray that you would override my preparation, Lord. I pray, Holy Spirit, na ikaw, Jud, ang maghatag o power ani nga time. Take full control of this, O Lord, in Jesus' name. And I believe that your word will not return to you null and void, but it would really accomplish the purpose for which you sent it, O God. We all honor you, we love you, and we really are amazed that you are our God. In Jesus' name we pray, Amen. So, unsa gatong title? Crossing over. Is it a go or stay? Ingon sila na dali ra ko no kaayo madani. Dali ra kaayo madala. Dali ra kaayo mapalid. Na ito'y kanta si Katy Perry before. Unsa ganito? Do you ever feel like a plastic bag drifting through the wind wanting to start again? Dali ra kaayo no magpadala sa algo sabay sa uso. Dali ra siya because all you need to do is nothing. Just go with the flow. Walay resistance involved. Early this year kay nami ato sa Batangas kay naay strategic planning sa mga destiny pastors and katong among gistay na place na siya'y wakeboarding. So nag-try me. Kuyog na ko ato si James, si Pastor Nathan, si Pastor Butch, si Pastor Kai, and then we tried. Akala na mo na sayon ra kay ang imulagong buhaton kay mag-hold lang ka og lubid, and then mutungtong lang ka sa wakeboard, and then ang katong lubid mag-drag lang sa imuha, and dapat imo lang i-steady ang imo position, mutindog lang ka sa wakeboard. It appeared easy. Pero actually, lisod yun siya. Lisod mag-stay put nga nagtindog. Dali ra kaayo ka madala. Dali ra kaayo ka matumba. Sila Pastor Nathan, Pastor Butch, and even si James, layo-layo ito sila naabtan. Pero kami ni Kai, inig-andar, gamay lang nga distance, tumba dayon. Kaya lisod. It would require certain level of skill and technique to really resist ang katong movement and to continue na mag-remain ka na nag-stand, standing position. So listen actually no ang mag-ano, mag-stay put. In Hebrews chapter 2 verse 1, we are told that is why we must hold on all the more firmly to the truths we have heard so that we will not be carried away. Sa Tagalog translation, kaya dapat nating pag-ukulan ng higit pang pansin ang mga bagay na ating narinig. Baka tayo'y matangay na papalayo. Sabi dyan, kailangan daw nato mag-hold on firmly. Sa ibang translation, pay most careful attention. Pag-ukulan ng pansin. Unsa may pag-ukulan ng pansin? Ang mga bagay daw na narinig. The truths that you have heard. The teachings that you have been taught, dapat daw gunitan, dapat daw i-recall, dapat daw i-pay attention, or else you will be carried away. Murag atong wakeboarding. Murag ikaw, you will be drifting away. Diba? Matatangay daw tayo, papalayo. It is true. Dali ra kaayo ta matangay papalayo from what we believe, from our faith, especially during difficult times right now, like now. And this happened to the family we are going to talk about. Go with me sa Ruth chapter 1. The book of Ruth. And we're going sa verses 1 to 5. Let me read. In the days when the judges ruled, there was a famine in the land, and men of Bethlehem in Judah went to sojourn in the country of Moab, he and his wife and his two sons. The name of the man was Elimelech, and the name of his wife was Naomi, and the names of his two sons were Mahlon and Chilion. They were Ephrathites from Bethlehem in Judah. They went into the country of Moab and remained there. But Elimelech, the husband of Naomi, died, and she was left with her two sons. These took Moabite wives. The name of the one was Orpah, and the name of the other Ruth. They lived there about 10 years, and both Mahlon and Chilion died, so that the woman, Naomi, was left without her two sons and her husband. So, mao na nga ito ang pagstoryaan karon. Let's look at this historical account up close. Question, when did this occur? We are given the answer. This occurred during the time of Judges. Tansa man ang time of Judges. Sige, ato lang i-backtrack ka diyot para kasabuta sa background. So, kabalutan o, si Abraham, gikol ni Lord, padung sa Promised Land. And then, nanganak siya, si Isaac. Then si Isaac, may anak, si Jacob. And then si Jacob, nagkaroon ng 12 sons. Samo na to ang patriarch sa Israel. And then, naging tribe to kada anak ni Jacob. And then, eventually, nagsettle sila sa Egypt. And then, na-enslave sila sa Egypt for more than 300 years. And then, the Lord called Moses to deliver the entire land of Israel from slavery. So, gikuha sila ni Moses. And then, tungod silang unbelief, they were really running in circles sa wilderness for 40 years. And then, gitupod sa wilderness, gi-establish ni Lord ang nation of Israel. Naghatag siya mga order, naghatag siya mga laws para sa ilang kapakanan. So dito po to na institute po ang mga burnt offering, gi-institute po ang mga laws ni Lord. And then what happened? The entire generation died except kay Caleb and Joshua. And we know sa katong-atong we talk about last time, finally when Joshua became leader, he successfully led the entire nation to cross over the Jordan River into the Promised Land. And then ilang i-conquer ang mga lands dito, katong Jericho, katong Ai, and they were able to settle the land. And then what happened? Judges 2:10. After that whole generation had also been gathered to their fathers, another generation rose up who did not know the Lord or the work that He had done for Israel. So after namatay ang ka-generation ni Joshua, ang nipuli nga generation, wala kaila ni Lord, o wala kahibaw kung unsa gibuhat ni Lord. So nalimta nila si Lord, so unsa gibuhat ani nga mga tao, tungod wala sila kaila ni Lord, they really followed. Naman kayo mga inhabitants nga wala nila completely na wipe out. They followed katong mga culture, katong mga gituuan, atong mga tao. They really gave themselves into idolatry. And then, as a result, God chastised them. God really disciplined them. Na yung mga people nga mo-conquer sila, mo-oppress sila. And then, sa kanang bingit sa kalisuran, bingit sa kamatayan, these people would call out to the Lord for help. Help us, oh God, help us. And then, the Lord would raise up judges to really rule, to really deliver His people. So, muna sila Jephthah, sila Samson. They were really, deliverers, mga judges. And then, gikabaw po ta nga during the time of Judges, unsa giingon, Judges chapter 21 verse 25. In those days, there was no king in Israel. Everyone did what was right in his own eyes. And we also talked about this said before, na during the time of Judges, walay order, walay standard, everybody is right. Whatever you wanna do it. Walay manghilabot nimo. And it resulted to a very chaotic na land, very chaotic na country. So maotong na ato'y kanang Levite, di ba nga, iyang gichap-chap ang iyang concubine, basta gubot jud to. And that is the time of Judges. And that is where, that is when, kaning story ni Ruth nag-transpire. So, mauna, ang time sa Judges. Unsa pa, ingon po dira, Ruth 1:1, in the days when the judges ruled, there was a famine in the land. So, kanusta po din nahitabo, no? There was a famine in the land of Judah. Pag mag-ingon ta o famine, what do we mean by that? It's a time of great hunger. It's a time of scarcity. Kulangon yun. It did not rain. So, ang mga crops namatay. And then, ang mga animals po, dili well-fed. So, eventually, nangamatay po sila. And many times in the Bible, famine is seen as coming from the Lord, as judgment for the sins of people. Makita nato na sa Leviticus, sa Deuteronomy, and even sa Genesis. Even po sa time nila David. And then, di-mention to na because the people did not pay attention, di ba? They were the people in during the time of Judges. They were not paying attention. So maybe the Lord sent famine to discipline the people and call them to repentance. Ang mga tao, no, hangtod kayang mulusot, mulusot. Hangtod kaya mo survive, mo survive. Dira na lang jud kung grabe na maglisod, dira pa mo sampit sa pangalan sa Ginoo. It was really a difficult time, but God remained in control and He was accomplishing His purposes during the times of famine. Unsa pa? Who? Kinsa may involved ani? Ruth 1 verse 2. The name of the man was Elimelech, and the name of his wife Naomi, and the names of his two sons were Mahlon and Chilion. They were Ephrathites from Bethlehem in Judah. They went into the country of Moab, and they remained there. So who kinsay involved ani? Family composed of Elimelech, ang husband, ang father, and then ang wife nga si Naomi, and then ang duha nila nga anak nga si Mahlon ug si Chilion. So, makagiingon dira, they are Ephrathites. And ingon sa Bible history, ang mga Ephrathites, they are really noble family. So, makaingon ta nga wealthy ni sila, well-off ni sila, promising. And maayo pud no na when we read the Bible, we also get to understand what their name means. Kay most of the names of the Israelites, na yung mga meaning. Nakatry na pud ba mo Google sa inyong name? Masa kay meaning sa inyong name? Ang natoy time nga nag-try po kong Google sa akong name, and then ang meaning daw sa Ken kay Wisdom. Char lang. So, yun. So, ano yung meaning nga nila mga names? Very interesting. Si Elimelech, ang meaning sa yung name kay My God is my King. Elimelech, My God is my King. Si Naomi, meaning sa yung name, Merry Sunshine. Delightful. Sweet. Amazing, no? Naomi. Mahlon, meaning sa yung name. Sickly, masakiton. Si Chilion, meaning sa yung name. Wasting away. Grabe, ang ilang mga pangalan. So, dili ko sure kung from birth na ba sila yung mga defects. Pero mao na ilang pangalan. We were not told if napubri sila tungod sa famine, or do they just want to preserve their wealth? Monang before losing everything, they decided to sojourn sa Moab during the time of famine. But regardless of this, the head of the family, Elimelech, decided to cross over. So what? Unsay nahitabo ani nga time? There was a crossover from Bethlehem in Judah into the land of Moab to sojourn there. When we say sojourn, it means temporary stay. So, mo to ilang plan. Muhawa sila from Bethlehem para magstay temporarily sa Moab. So, thinking to preserve the family from famine, Elimelech took the entire family to cross over. From where? From Bethlehem to Moab. Bethlehem, maayo po ito makabalo sa meaning ani. Ang meaning sa Bethlehem, Beth, house, lehem or lechem, bread. So it's a house of bread. So it signifies a land that is abundant, a land that is fruitful, plentiful. Pero tungod nag-famine, things are not the same. Dili okay ang situation dito. We know po na significant ng Bethlehem. Dito gipanganak si David. Dito po siya na anoint bilang king. And eventually, dito po gipanganak si Jesus. And then, modo na ang Bethlehem. Na ay map dira karon. So, Bethlehem na sa west side. Muagi pa ka og mga bukid. Munaog pa ka. And then, mulabang pa ka sa Jordan River. And then, musaka na po ka og bukid. Muagi pa ka og mga plains. And then, muabot ka sa land of Moab. So, mo na ang ilang gi-crossover. Teka lang. Diba, they are already in the promised land. Kaya remember mo sila Joshua, gikan sa east ni adto sa west? Pero nga no, naunsa man ni dire, gikan sa west ni adto man sa east. Yes, they were in the promised land. Did they really go out from the promised land? Yes, they went out from the promised land. And where? To Moab. If you would remember sa Genesis, kinsay ancestor aning Moab? Ang kaning land, people of Moab, no? It was a fruit sa incest. Katong anak ni Lot, nakipag-sipi sa yaha, kay wala daw lain, and then naanak ni. Duha man to, yung daughter. So, naanak nila si Moab o si kanang Ammon. Muna mga Moabite, mga Ammonite. Sa ilahang papa. dili gyud to siya okay. And then unsa pa? It's a land in the eastern side of the Jordan River where God is not worshipped. Ang ilang deity dito kay si Chemosh, very ang minisayang name the destroyer. Kay si Chemosh very bloody. Ang uso dito kay human sacrifice. Like na ako'y na-watch nga movie before sa Book of Ruth, ang mga bata yun, they would really feel it an honor na ang bata is sacrifice sa altar. Like pat yun yun siya. Mauna si Chemosh. And if ka remember po ta, maupod ni ang katuganing si King Balak, King of Moab to siya. Katong iyang gisogo si Balaam, si Balaam na i-curse ang Israel. Pero kabalo man ta si Balaam na di dapat i-curse ang Israel. So what did he do? Iyan na lang gitudluan ang Moabites. Unsay buhaton. I-entice na lang ning mga Israelites. Bawal man na sa ilaha makipag-asawa sa uban. Pero ang kaning ang nahitabo, gi-seduce ang mga lalaki, ni give in ang lalaki kani yung gugma, no? Usahay kung gugma-gugma, wala na sakto, wala na yung commandment ni Lord, basta go-go-go lang. And as a result, sa katong sin nga ilang gibuhat, the Lord sent plague, which killed 24,000 people. So, mauna siya ang Moab. Diba? But of all places, nga nung dito man ni crossover, ang family ni Elimelech. Nato yung article nga nag-ingon na pag dito na ko nagpuyo sa Bethlehem, and then kanang mo gawas kagamay sa kanang mga fields, iniktanaw gani mo sa southeast, makita ni mo ang Moab, ang well-watered na plain sa Moab. So siguro, makadani jud samtang magtanong ka dito, kaya makompare niyo, hala, grabe ka, lisod diri, pero dito, kaya mo nagmindot, laki kaayo. May pa dito, diri in town, lisod. Aware man si Elimelech sa kaning history sa Moab, kaning incest, kaning Chemosh, katong nahitabo kay Balaam, pero ang iyang hiwanahuna, ang iya na lang pagka-rescue, ang sa iyang family, ang ilahan na lang pagka-spare, makaalingkawas lang sila sa famine in the land. So, they crossed over. It was a challenging crossover, about 16,000 kilometers na og bukid sa kabukid, and then ni cross pud sila sa Jordan River. But they fled for safety. They fled to save their lives from the famine. It was initially a sojourn, a temporary stay. Pabalipasin lang siguro dapat nila ang famine, and then eventually mabalik sila. But what happened? Ingon to sa tong ibasa ganina, Ruth 1, Verse 2, they went into the country of Moab and remained there. And actually, they stayed there for more than 10 years. Ang ilang temporary stay, naging long term. So there are several problems with this crossover. Allow me to give you 6. Yes, hindi lahat ng crossover ay tama. So, unsa kita nang tahito? Crossing over. Is it a go? Or is it a stay? So some problems with this crossover. First, Elimelech did not consult the Lord. Elimelech did not consult the Lord. There was no mention or whatever about Elimelech consulting the Lord whether to cross over to Moab or to stay behind in Bethlehem. He did not ask the Lord about it. He did not wait for God's word regarding it. He jumped immediately into action. Iya siguro gihuna-huna ang welfare sa iyang family. Yes, that is good. Pero ang iyang paghuna-huna sa welfare sa iyang family, more than sa iyang paghuna-huna to live a life of obedience unto the Lord. Ma-remind lang tano, masigiingon sa Luke chapter 14 verse 26. If anyone comes to me and does not hate father and mother, wife and children, brothers and sisters, yes, even their own life, such a person cannot be my disciple. it's not wrong to care for our families. In fact, the Bible commands us to take care of our families. Isa po na sa reason nga nung nasuko si Jesus sa mga Pharisee, kay grabe kaayo mag-ingon-ingon, pero wala dito nag-take care sa ilang mga pamilya. But if ang atong families na, ang welfare o needs na sa atong family, mo go na siya beyond sa atong concern kay Lord, more than God, then something is wrong. Ang giingon dira, if anyone comes to me and does not hate mother, father, brother, sister, children, wife, mo say ingon, he could not be my disciple. Ang kaning giingon nga hate, dili man siya kalabutan ni mo imong pamilya para ang Ginoo ra imong igugmaon. It's not like that. It's like na ginani dayni. Grabe ka in love kay Lord na ang imong love sa ubang tao in comparison mura na siya og hate. Because to you, God is your priority. God comes first. So, Mona, second problem about this crossing over. Elimelech relied on his logic. To him, it was the best decision. Family naman diri, lisod naman ni diri, wala naman ni pag-asa diri, dili nami mabuhi diri, at to na lang tas muwag. Unsa naman gitawag panig-promised land kung ingon ani raman di ay? Famine naman di ay, mo cross over na lang mi. Lord, i-bless ang among trip, i-bless ang kanina decision. Something fishy. Nag-ask na i-bless ni Lord ang decision without even asking the Lord unsa ang iyang decision. Usahay ingon ana ta, we don't ask for the plans and will of God. We make our own plans and then ask God to bless our own plan. Makarelate ta ni tanan, Lord, i-bless ang akong work. Lord, i-bless ni akong buhaton. Lord, i-bless ni akong relationship. We are asking God to bless our plan. Pero wala ganita ng mutana kay Lord, unsa, in the first place, ang iyang plan. Unsaon pag-bless ni Lord ang usa ka butang na dili pud gikan sa iyaha. How could God bless a plan na dili mangyud iyaha? Lord, dili na jud ni madala. Muhawa na jud ko diri ng work. I am not celebrated here. And hawa you go without even asking the Lord. Lord, dili na jud ni makaya. Na-hurt na jud ko ani nga relationship. Ah, mang-block na ko. Ah, mag-friendship over na ko. Ah, mang-layas na ko. I will call it quits na. And then, out you go without even asking the Lord if this was His will. Are you with me? Third problem about this crossing over. Elimelech was lured by the greener pasture that Moab offered. Elimelech was lured by the greener pasture that Moab offered. Excuse me. Pag magkalisod tano, anything that would offer escape would automatically feel to be the better option. Normally, di ba, mga Filipino family, ang ilang thinking, successful ka kung mag-abroad ka. Without even thinking, no, na lisod actually ang abroad. Ang mga tao dito, dili hayahay. They like, naku, yung mga kailang, mga relatives, mga friends, mutik sila og 2 or 3 jobs or uban 4 pa just to be able to sustain themselves and then magpadala pa sa diri sa Philippines. Masaya na tayo yun, Ana, ang katong naasa layo, mo na ang mas nindot, mo na ang mas maayo, mo na ang greener pasture, diri sa ato, ah, bati na siya. Diba? Sige, tag-ingon, may pa dito. May pa sauna. May pa sila. Usually, sa simula lang na. Kis sa inyo ha na kay disciple niya. Imo siyang disciple for 3 years na. Nasigkag, reklamo kay Lord, ganun siya, man akong disciple. Sakit sa ulo, gahi o ulo. Diba, pabadlong man kayo ni, and then akay mamit na new person. Wala ka buutan ani niya, sana all. Sana tanang disciple like this. Well, inana imong thinking, inana imong feeling, kay wala pa mang kakailanan niya. Watch out, lalabas din ang true colors ng person na yan. So, ingin anak, kapag bago Pag dili tayo ita familiar, murag, mas nindot, mas amazing, without realizing na mas lisod di ay to. Diba? Mugawas mo, mga relationship, diba? Nga nung naamay maintahis nga mga bit, or mga liwa, or unsapan na. Kasi, nag-think sila, mas better ni sa ako ang wife, na ako yung mga needs nga dili ma-meet sa akong husband, ako ni kuha akong dira. Pero, not realizing, it would really lead to ruin. In Jeremiah chapter 48, verse 11, we are told, Moab has been at ease from his youth. He has settled on his dregs and has not been emptied from vessel to vessel, nor has he gone into captivity. Therefore, his taste remained in him, and his scent has not changed. From this, murag makaingon ta na Moab seems to be a comfortable land. Ingon di ka? Has been born at ease since pagkabata and hangtod ni tigulang. Comfortable. Siguro nag-think to si Elimelech, ganong dili naman lang sa Moab ang promised land? Ganong dili man sa Israel? Ganong dili man sa Judah? Nga kalisudra diri? Kitang mga people makarelate ana, no? Sometimes, wala tayo regard sa unsa ang will ni Lord, asa, basta, asa ang masayod, muna na. Asa ang masure, mas secure, mas at ease, muna na. Mas comfortable, mas easy, mauna na. Not really reminding, no? Remembering that narrow is the road that leads unto the Lord. Wala ta kabalo. Unsa sila ka, dugay nga, nag-wait nga, mahuman ang famine. And unsa pod niya ka, dugay gi-ponder ang pag-crossover sa promised land. Siguro na ay mga days nga, kanang, ay mo add to sa Moab na yung mga days nga mo anas magtrabaho siya na mag-think siya maybe this is the day na ma-lift na ang famine, yay! So magtrabaho siya dito, excited siya, and then wala man na-lift ang famine. Kita siya, ang iyang tanong, green pa to, nagkaanang o katuyo, nahahalo sa kainit, nangasunog na. And then, tanaw siya sa layo. Sa to, southeast daw. Kita siya. Lo, green. Yellow man niri. Lo, may tubig. Lo, uga man niri. Ay, mas nindot siguro dito. How I wish I will be there. Life is better there. Maybe in ana ang nahitabo, no? Not considering si Elimelech unsa giingon sa Deuteronomy chapter 23 verse 3. Let's go there. An Ammonite or Moabite shall not enter the assembly of the Lord, even to the tenth generation. None of his descendants shall enter the assembly of the Lord forever. Kami, they were told not to associate with the Moabites. Much more, mag-live with them. Pero to Elimelech, wala na rin siya ni matter. Number 4, problem with this crossing over. Elimelech did not live up true to his name. Elimelech did not live up true to his name. What does his name mean? My God is my king. My God is my king. But the decisions that he made, katong iyang consideration, katong iyang eventual nga pag-crossover, paghawa, gikan sa promised land, padulong sa land of Moab, na seemingly mas comfortable, seemingly mas ease. He did not consider the Lord. So actually, it was not the Lord who is the king of his life. He was king. It was not the will of God that mattered to him. It was his own will. Maybe sometimes we are like Elimelech. We call ourselves Christian. We call ourselves disciples of Jesus. We call ourselves followers. Yet when difficult situations come our way, we pay no regard to God and then do things our own way. Dili gyud si God ang king. Maay lang ta mag-ingon-ingon. Katong giingon pa ni Lord sa mga Pharisees, no? Your mouth, You honor me with your lips, but your heart is far from me. Kumuingon mo gutang king, you are my king, Lord. Ibig sabihin, the Lord is our master. The Lord is our ruler. The Lord is the authority. The Lord is the owner. The Lord is supreme. And the Lord is the highest in our life. Is it true? Ingon pa to ni Pastor Edmond Chan, if the Lord is not Lord of all, then maybe He is not Lord at all. Are we living up true to our name, Christians? Or hanggang pangalan lang ba tayo? Na I disconnect between what we say and what we actually live out. It's not enough na hanggang name lang. It's not enough to say na, sa destiny bita ko tig church, okay na na. Ay, akong family bita ko kay Christian, okay na na. It's not like that. It doesn't work like that. Do you call yourself a disciple of God? But the question is, are you truly surrendered to His will? Kasi baka hindi si Lord ang king ng buhay. Baka tayo pa din. Just like what happened kay Elimelech. What if ang will ni Lord sa toa is one that would require pain and endurance? Would we continue? Or muhawa na lang ta? Problem number 5 with this crossing over. Elimelech did not understand God's purpose for the famine. Elimelech did not understand God's purpose for the famine. There's a reason and a purpose for the famine. God, being sovereign that He is, He does not do anything without any reason, without any purpose. Nothing happens by accident. Everything has a purpose. Even in the Bible, the occurrences of the different famines, no? It was all for a purpose. Let's cite one. Go with me to Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 24. I will send wasting famine against them, consuming pestilence and deadly plague. I will send against them the fangs of wild beasts, the venom of vipers that glide in the dust. Kani daw mga famine, no? They are God's judgment. He is just. And sin could not just be easily let go nang walang proper punishment, walang proper justice. Second, ang kaning mga famine ma-remind ta sa power ni God. That our God is really in control. Appeal na dira ang nature. Kanus amo ulan, kanus amo init. And then third, ang kanipong mga famine, it is to discipline us so that we would be corrected, we would improve, and we would be mature. Kakita na mag mga tao nga, tigulang na, pero spoiled gihapon, kaya na sila, wala na sila gi-discipline pagbata. Ingon sa Proverbs chapter 3, verse 12, because the Lord disciplines those He loves, as a father, the son He delights in. Are you experiencing mga famine sa inyong life karon? Maybe it's because God is disciplining you. And why is that? You are His beloved child. Ingon pa sa Psalms 119, verse 71, it is good for me that I have been afflicted, that I might learn His statutes. Many times, kailangan patag difficulty, kailangan patag affliction before we would ever learn. Ingon pa sila, experience daw ko no, is the best teacher. Hanggat di pa masakit, hanggat napatay, kanang kaya pa, na ate tendency magpatuloy, kahit alam na to, nga mali na. Hanggat walang consequence, we can fool ourselves na okay lang ni. Pero dili na ingon ana. Elimelech, being an Ephratite, katong atong giingon ganina, noble. So wealthy ang ilang background. Wala siguro ni siya naanad o difficulty. Naanad ni siya og comfortable na lifestyle, well-fed, well-off. He is not accustomed to living in distress. He was really naanad siya life of ease and wealth. Mulisod actually ang mga tao nga pampered, no? Nga musabak sa mga difficulty. Kay the slightest lang inconvenience, mudagan. Kay wala maanad. Ikaw, anad ba ka? Kita sa inyo dari sa kadaghan ni mong giagian sa kinabuhi, nagpasalamat ka. Kita niya mga difficulty no, giligon gyud ka. Ingon sa James chapter 1 verse 2 to 4, "My brethren, count it all joy when you fall into various trials, knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience. But let patience have its perfect work, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking nothing." Pampered, at ease, well-off, comfortable people, they have no opportunity to develop patience, to develop perseverance, to develop character. As a result, ang ilaha pong pagkatao, kulang-kulang, immature, di ba? Ilimilek, instead of allowing God to accomplish His purpose in the famine, He ran away into Moab. He escaped. Sa atong difficult times karon with this pandemic, no? It's not really easy. It's painful. But we can know for sure that God has a purpose for this. So, unsa man atong response? Do we just want na we everything mahuman na gid ni? Or are we learning our lesson here? Maybe in this time, God is exposing idols, mga security, false security nimo, apart from God. Saan mo pagkahibaw nga mo na imong idol? Pagtanggalo na, and then grabe ang imong kawalan, maybe that is an idol. That is a security. Diba? Kwaon. Hugno. Hugno ka. Maybe mag-ingon ka na God is your security, but ang reality dili. You are not really complete in the Lord. Pangita og ubang mga butang. The reality, my friends, is this. All of us will be tested. Sa ayaw man natin or sa hindi. And in Elimelech's case, he was tested. The famine was the test. Sige, ko ginani kayo. Katul na pala kang ilong. The famine was the test. It was a test of faith, commitment, devotion, loyalty, perseverance. But when the famine came, instead of trusting God, what did he do? He wanted something tangible. He was lured with what he was seeing and crossed over without the approval of God. So, scanning faith test, no? Endurance test, Elimelech failed. Last problem with this crossing over. 6. Elimelech went out of God's will. Elimelech went out of God's will. There is a geographic dimension to the will of God. Kaya example, ngayon si Abraham gipaadto pa mangyud sa Israel, pwede naman siya mag-remain sa Ur in Chaldea para i-accomplish ni God yung purpose dito. Ngayon si Moses, kailangan mangyud dito sa east side, sa promised land, east side, sa Jordan River, ngano di man pwede sa wilderness. Di ba? Ingon ana, there is a geographic dimension to the will of God. Judah was the promised land, but Elimelech and his entire family went out of the promised land into the land of Moab. And unsa ng Moab? We're given a glimpse in Psalms 108 verse 9. Ingon si Lord dito, "Moab is my wash basin." Palanggana lang ni Lord ang Moab. Sa ubang translation ko, no? "Moab is my garbage bin." Ingon ana, gipagpalit ni Elimelech ang promised land for garbage bin sa temporary na pagka-ease sa iyahang issues during the time of difficulty, sa katong famine. Grabe, no? What did they do? They left God's promised land and went into Moab. Usa pa, they also left God's people. Asa na ang people ni God? Naa dito. Sa Bethlehem. Naa dito. Sa Judah. But they left it. Wala tayo sure na. Basta like kaila sa Moab. Pero ilang gibyaan ang mga tao. A people of God. Ilang gibyaan. What did they leave pa? They left God's leaders. Abalota. Ang mga judges, they were really imperfect leaders. But God instituted nonetheless. Pero gibyaan na. Siguro nanis na yung mga aligot-got sa gobyerno nila. So, ingon sila, dito na lang ta. Para kita'y gobyerno. I don't know. They also left God's worship. Asa mo ito gina-worship si Lord? Naman ito'y mga specific na ordained na places ng mga altar. Kung asa mag-offer o sacrifices, asa ang mga burnt offering. Pero kung muato sila sa Moab, wala na yun na ito. So they did not just live the promised land, they actually left the worship of God. In Moab, they could not worship God there. Wala po'y priest dito. Grabe, no? Okay rato, nila Elimelech nga biyaan ang katong pag-worship kay God para lang ma-spare sa famine. And unsa pa, they did not just leave the promised land, they did not just leave God's people, they did not just leave God's worship, God's leaders, they also leave God. They left God and went to a place where a different God was worshipped. Murag, in ato di ang implication ato, ang binanghog, lihok-lihok lang ni, pero dako man di ay. Ingon ana, makita na ito, murag ang mahirap, pero kung tanawang yun ni mo, sa root, perting dako aday sa issue. Nato'y time nga, nakakita ko black-black sa ako ang ipo, na isakit siya eventually, and eventually gibunot, and then shocking, ang binanghog, gamayra ang cavity, gamayra ang tooth decay, pero hasta di ay abot sa root ang problema. Kung una-una ito, no? If it was the will of God to save them, the entire people of Israel, nga nung wala man ni crossover ang entire nation padulong sa Moab, nga nung sila Elimelech raman ang ni crossover, basin sila lang siguro ang wala naka-agwanta, wala naka-endure. Ang mga people nag-stay behind man. Elimelech did not wait for the redemption of God. Kibalo man tayo ni, wala'y problema nga magdugay. Kitawagan na siya pinagdadaanan kay daanan. And ang punishment ni God, dili na forever. But Elimelech did not wait for the redemption of God. Instead, he placed matters into his hands and then nag-cross over for the fear nga maunsa na lang ni ang welfare sa iyang family. Fear really makes us do crazy things. Lisod ang fear, especially kung ang imo ang security pod kay sayop ang pagkabutang. Wala nila ang security para mas secure kay Lord. So kung imong security nasa imong kwarta, nasa imong trabaho, nasa imong pamilya, nasa imong self, dili gyud na siya tinuoray nga security. Grabe gyud ka kahadlok ana. Gibyaan ang tanan ni Elimelech just to be safe. Elimelech actually drifted away. And because he was the leader of the family, he also caused his family to drift away as well. Kung okay ra niya na wala ni tanan, wala ang promised land, wala ang people ni God, wala ang worship ni Lord, wala ang church, wala ang word ni God, wala si God mismo, nag-drift na gid ni. Kita ka ha, no? Are we also drifting? Some telltale signs that we have already drifted or drifting. Una, there's a loss of desire to read and study His Word. Wala kay appetite. Di na makaya ra nimo mabuhi nga dili mag-spend time sa Word ni Lord. Para nimo added lang sa imong mga tasks. Lisod na isingit sa imong schedule. Unsa pa, second, a loss of desire to fellowship with God's people. Na kay care, church or dili church, online or dili online, bahala sila, mag-live na ko sa akong own life. Drifting na. Third, a loss of desire to share the good news. this is the reason, di ba, why we're here, to really reconcile people to the Lord, to share the good news of God's salvation to the lost people. Kaya it's not just, ingat pag ito si Edmund Chan, some people, they are so afraid to die. But ang dapat ay natong kahadlukan, no, is not really death, but to not have the life. Na yung mga people na existing lang, pero dili giday buhi. Pero ang reality po, there's life after death. So kung wala ka kaila kay Lord, kay Jesus, wala kay life after death, na kay life after death, kasi mahitabo, hell. And kung mawalaan ka burning passion to share this good news, anong good news man? Because we don't need to do anything. Jesus already accomplished everything on the cross. So kailangan natong buhaton to believe. Pero kung wala na kay hugot ani sa imong heart, na na yung mga laing butang sa imong kasing-kasing, you're drifting. Unsa pa, there's an increased desire for pleasure. Yan na lang ka, wali buhaton, matulog, mag-lazy-lazy, mag-binge-watching, mag-unsa-unsa, mag-games or whatever. Not that they're wrong, pero ang imong passion for this greater passion in spiritual disciplines, you are already drifting. And there's also an increased desire for comfort. Tika ngayon maglisod, yun na nakaugsa yun. Drifting. If we find ourselves compromising our relationship with God sa ngalan ng practicality, sa ngalan ng rest, friends, we are actually drifting. And something about drifting, no? Drifting is a slow process. Sa pagka-slow, many times, hindi ka kahibalo nga ni drift na ka up until layo na ka o gilagputan. You don't care what God has to say. You just want to save yourself. You just want to survive. You don't really trust in the Lord, but your trust is in your own wisdom. Mo itong atong first verse nga gibasa ganina sa Hebrews chapter 2 verse 1. Sa tuingon dito, we must pay the most careful attention, therefore, to what we have heard so that we do not drift away. Are you paying attention? Unsa man ang imong na-hear? What is the truth? What is that lesson that you heard? What is that word that you heard? Are you really holding on to it? Okay, if not, you're drifting away. And you know what? Difficulty has its way of revealing things. Sa ako ang life, kadaghan na nga, kaning mga difficulty ang naging cause nga mo drift away ko. Na yung mga times nga, I would want to quit on church, even way back college, para ma-save ko no akong academics. Ganaan ko, ma-save mga academics, bahala na natan ng mga commandments ni Lord, I will save my life, drifting away. But I thank God for His grace. Nagpabilin niya ako karon, pero naako na yung daghan nga episodes, especially pag ma-challenge ang self-worth, ma-challenge, ma-bombarded ko, mga negative thoughts. Really, na yung mga people na yung mga opportunities sa finances, mga greener pastures, grab da yun without considering the word of God, not knowing na outside na di ito sa will ni God. Is this happening to us? Can we relate to that? What is being exposed sa karon is difficult situation, are we trusting God or are we already drifting away? And ang masaklap pa, nagdi-drift na, hindi pa natin nalalaman. Let's go back to Elimelech's family and then we're going to close. Ruth 1, verse 3 to 5. But Elimelech, the husband of Naomi, died, and she was left with her two sons. This took Moabite wives, the name of the one was Orpah, and the name of the other Ruth. They lived there about 10 years, and both Mahlon and Chilion died, so that the woman Naomi was left without her two sons and her husband. What happened after their crossover? What happened? Elimelech died. We don't know how soon, but he died. And then, unsay nahitabo? Mahlon and Chilion, they married, and dili dugay, what happened to them? Malon, and Killian died. Quite an irony. Naatoy sa ka-family nga four members, si Elimelech, si Naomi, si Malon, si Killian, ni cross over from Bethlehem to Moab to save their life. What happened? The three died, leaving Naomi behind. What an irony. Mo nang giingon, no? The more we hold on to our life, the more we will lose it. But the more we will lose our life for the sake of God, the more we have gained it. Grabe ang irony. Ingon pa sa Proverbs chapter 14, verse 12, there is a way that seems right to a man, but in the end, it leads to death. They were thinking not to die. We're going to die here in the promised land tungod sa famine. Let's go there. Mas greener pasture sa Moab. Dito sila namatay. Quite an irony. So ultimately, what's our lesson na mag-glean nato from here? It is this. Do not leave the place God put you, no matter how difficult it gets. Don't live without a clear direction from the Lord. Ayaw hawa kung asa ka gibutang ni Lord. Hangtod, dili ka kakadungog o klaro na pahawaon na ka ni Lord dira, maski naglisod pa ka dira. Dili ibig sabihin naglisod, automatic mo pahawa na. Maybe ang calling ni Lord sa ato ah, kay mo persevere, to stand firm, to continue, to press on despite the difficulties. Ingon pa to si Dr. Mike Bagwell. If you are where God wants you, don't leave. Even if things get a little unpleasant, and they will, let your green lights all come from the Lord. Makita nato, no, ang sana, luoy jud kung ang tao, ang gisaligan lang ang kaugalingon. Dili gyud siya tinuoray. Elimelech placed matters into his hands, and ang iyahang gisave nga life maupod ang nawala nga life. Drita makabaw, no, that our real refuge is not in those amazing logically nga coherent na places. Our real refuge is the Lord. The safest place to be is in the center of the will of God. So don't leave when God hasn't told you. Don't cross over unless the Lord has told you. Ayaw ibutang ang mga bagay-bagay sa atong kamot. Musamot na nooy. Are you with me? Ingon pa si Catherine Morgan, committing to follow Christ necessarily requires His input in our destination. We go when He says go. We wait when He says stay. When He says wait. Grabe. Let it be that the one who would direct our paths is the Lord and not ourselves. When problems come, even famine, stay put. Stay there. Wait until God says go. Huwag mong iwan, ibaliwala ang lahat because lang sa mga hardships. Amen? This is also a reminder for our faith to remain constant. Naatay faith pag okay ang tanan. Dali na kaayo mo ito pag okay ang tanan. Uy, example, kanyang mga married couples, ilang wedding, for richer or poorer, diba? Until death do us apart. They mean that. Pero pag magkalisod na, malimta na. Dali lang magka-faith pag okay ang mga circumstances, pero magkalisod na, dira ang magkailanay. But guys, let our faith be constant. Regardless of the situation, regardless of the circumstance, let us always have faith. Let us hold on to the Word of God so that we will not drift away. Amen? Let's hold on. Question, are you drifting away in these difficult times? Nagplano ba kang mag-stop o follow kay Lord? Nagplano ba kang i-quit na? Or minsan na, nagplano ka sa imong own life? Mag-uwas na ka sa church, mabali na ka, mag-uwas na ka sa imong family, I don't know. But, huwag pa dalos-dalos up until we hear a clear direction from God. Let's stay there. Amen? It's dangerous. Amazing lang po no, sa kaning story nila, Elimelech. All hope is not lost. God's amazing redemption and providence came. And muna, ito ang pag-usapan sa next week, sa atong ituloy, ang kanyang amazing story sa life nila Elimelech, Naomi, Mahlon, Kilion. So, yun. I hope that you got something from what we shared today. Let's just really close in prayer now. Lord, salamat sa iyong word. I pray, O God, na ginamit mo yung word na to para mangusap sa bawat isa. Lord, this is really a word of warning, a word of rebuke. Na Lord, dali na ka lang kaayo magpa-drift away, and we could give all sorts of excuses. But Lord, in the end, when we put matters into our own hands, instead of things becoming better, things have actually become bitter, O God. Mas na worse na noon ang situation. Lord, we ask for forgiveness, Lord, that we're not looking at you. We're not holding on to your word. We're sorry for drifting away, O God. Lord, it's so easy to drift away. We just have to neglect, Lord, neglect you, neglect your word, neglect our spiritual discipline, and just allow the world to dictate. Take us, O Lord, what to do with our lives. And then for sure, drifting na gid mi, Lord. Lord, bring us back, O God. Bring us back, Lord. Allow us, Lord, to change course, Lord God. To steer, O God, into the right direction, Lord. Lord, humble us down. Maybe in this time, God is really working on your pride. God is exposing your lack so that you would not say you are sufficient on your own, but you need the Lord. We need God. We need God. There's no comfort. There's no leisure that could ever compare to the peace and security that we can find in the presence of God, in the will of God, in the plan of God. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Lord, Lord, grant us hope. Grant us, O God, hope, Lord, that as we really surrender our life to you, Lord, Lord, we would be able to sustain, O God, you would be able to sustain us in these difficult times, O God, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. We don't want to be people, God, who just say things and yet dili gyud na siya tinuod sa among ang kinabuhi. Whatever it is you are exposing sa among lives sa kaninga pandemic, O God, may you accomplish your purpose. Whatever difficulty you are allowing to expose us, O God, we just put our trust in you, Lord. Part of your sovereignty, Lord, means na nothing happens to us na dili ni agi sa imong approval, sa imong permission. So whatever happens, Lord, our trust is in you because you are in control, O God, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. If there are people here na your life dili pa gyud si Lord ang in control, I wanna tell you that today is the day of salvation. Ayaw hulata na nakasadulo sa imong rope before you return to God. Amazing ang grace ni God. Ingon to sa Corinthians no, na God made him who had no sin to be sin for us so that in him we may have the righteousness of God. Si Jesus, wala siya'y sala, wala siya nakasala. Kita ang daghang sala. Pero ang atong sala, iyang gibutang sa iyaha para kita maging righteous, maging karapat-dapat, maging matawag pa na anak niya. And unsa nga ato ang gibuhat dira, wala tay input, ang ato lang mutuo. Don't ever think that God is against you. Maybe God is allowing this difficult situation para muduol kaniya. Kaninga pain, it's actually an alarm system. for you, for us, to go back to God. If you haven't surrendered your life to the Lord, follow me in this prayer. I pray na dinini mo palang pason na opportunity. It may be your first time here or second time or baka napadpad lang ka, but I believe nothing happens by accident. God has a purpose for this. So if you want to surrender your life to the Lord, just follow me in this prayer. Lord Jesus, I ask for forgiveness na ako ang nag-control sa akong life. Na wala ako'y consideration sa imo ha. But I am realizing unsa ko kasayop, Lord. Unsa ko ka-foolish, Lord. Na ngayon kong pasaylo karon. Pasaylo ako, Lord, sa akong daghang sala. Pasaylo ako, Lord, sa ako ang dakong garbo. And karon, Lord, nituo ko ni Jesus, nituo ko sa iyang kamatayon sa cross o iyang pagabanhaw, nga napatawad yun ang akong mga kasalanan. And Lord, I ask for your forgiveness. Allow me to experience your forgiveness. Cleanse my life, O God, through and through. I wanna follow you, Lord. I wanna live a life that would bring, Lord, worship and glory to you, O God, in Jesus' name. If you are that person, let me just pray for you, Lord. To those who made that prayer, allow them to experience your forgiveness right now. Katong imong giingon, Lord, that as far as the east is from the west, so far will you remove our sins from us. Limpyuhi sila, O God. Lord, tanggala ang ilang panghunahuna ng bubot. Give them peace and allow them to be secured, O God, in your presence. Thank you so much for this morning. Thank you so much for your word. In Jesus' name, amen. Right now, let's just end with worshiping the Lord sa kaninga kanta nga liling. Indeed, God is only our true refuge.
Thanks for watching. Pray that the message you just heard today encouraged your hearts, and may the Lord use it to deepen our relationship with Him. For us to maximize the impact of God's Word in our lives, we need to apply it. We encourage you to join with us in the following discussion questions, which will be flashed in the screen. And for the next 5 minutes, discuss your answers with your small groups, friends, or your families who's watching with you at home. Have a great time in discussing your answers, and take time to pray afterwards.
Good morning, Destiny. My name is Carmel, and today I will be the one who will exhort with you on giving. So kindly go with me to 2 Corinthians 9:7. It says here, each of you should give what you have decided in your heart to give, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. So in this verse, it says here that the Lord wants us to be happy upon presenting our offering with Him, be it money, be it our time, be it our lives. There's been several accounts in the Bible where someone presented a heartful offering, and the Lord was really pleased. The Lord was really happy. For example, the woman who broke the alabaster jar at the feet of Jesus, they said it there that perfume will cost a year of wage. And a lot of people were not really happy about it. And instead, even the disciples, but Jesus was really happy in receiving that offering. So in this tough time, in the COVID-19 crisis, I believe some of us, we find it really difficult to give, not only to the church, but really to the people around us. Because sometimes in our minds, we really do not know what's going to happen, how long the pandemic will end, or how long will it take for us to go back to our normal lives. But, you know, the Bible says that the Lord is faithful. The Lord is faithful to those who is faithful to Him. So I really encourage everyone to really give to the Lord, a giving, an offering that is fit for a king. So I'll just end with this verse, 1 Corinthians 13:13. If I give all that I possess to the poor and give over my body to hardship that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. So there you go. I would like to acknowledge the VIPs today. I would like to thank you for joining us, and I hope you were blessed through the word. And I encourage you to join us again next Sunday. And I'd like to let you know that the giving is not compulsory. Again, the Lord wants a cheerful giver, and we would like you to be happy in your offering. So if you are willing, and if you'd like to give, you can do so. To those who have been faithful in their giving, I encourage you to continuously give. So the details where you can send your proceeds will be flashed on the screen after this. And if you have questions, or if you did not catch the details, you're free to send us a message at our Facebook page. Thank you so much, and I hope you have a blessed Sunday.
That this current situation cannot hinder us from going deep in the Lord. I hope that today we are reminded of God's faithfulness in our lives. If you have surrendered your life to the Lord, and if you have prayer requests or questions, feel free to message us on our Facebook page. And we invite you to join with us in our online life group, wherein you can be blessed, encouraged, and connected all throughout the week. We also have our own YouTube channel, wherein you can download the full Sunday service video if you can't watch it live. And if you happen to be watching alone now, please invite your friends, your loved ones, or your families to join with you next week. Thank you for being part of our family. Have a great Sunday, and God bless.